So this is a picture of me taken many years ago after one of my early data modeling assignments. And at the end of the year, I met with my manager to go over the projects I worked on and talk about what I did well and how I could do better next year. And you know how it is, you meet with your manager, you go through all your projects. Steve, you did good in this project and that project. Then I got really quiet in the room and I realized, okay, here's where it comes. I'm gonna get my feedback for the year. And the only comment my manager made for me to work on in the upcoming year was, Steve, you need to feel the data more. How do you feel data? I nodded my head, I said I would try, and I didn't know what that feedback meant, how to apply. And years later, looking back, I realized that's brilliant advice, because what we do in data modeling is it's all about feeling the data. It's all about understanding the data, documenting the data, communicating it to others. And that's what we talk about in this class, the Data Modeling Masterclass. So I'm Steve Hoberman, and I've been teaching data modeling since 1992. I've trained over 10,000 people on how to do data modeling. And what I cover in this three-day class are five top objectives. And I'll briefly go through them and then go through at a high level what modules we cover. The first objective is to apply techniques to elicit data requirements, including a question-driven approach, artifact analysis, and model playback. So what I do is I show all the techniques for how to build a model, and then once you build it, how do you read the data model? How do you read it, and how do you communicate it to others? Build relational and dimensional conceptual logical models, and know the trade-offs on the physical side for both relational database management systems and NoSQL. So in this class, we cover the five different types of data models. We go through each one of them in detail, and we practice building a lot of them. Build is the key word here. The way to remember what you learn in this class is to practice it, and we build lots of models. Validate any data model with key settings, as well as through the data model scorecard. So I have a very important camera analogy that I cover in this class, where I go through five settings in the camera and how each relates to a setting on the data model. In addition, I cover a technique called the data model scorecard, which is a set of 10 categories for reviewing the model. And it's the way I review models, and I've been reviewing models for many, many years. In fact, the whole class is organized around the scorecard technique. So it's not just a data modeling class about how do you model, although it does include that. It's all about how do you model well. It's all around best practices. Practice finding structural soundness issues, improving definitions, and verifying naming standards. So in this class, we cover all the ways to take a good model and make it better. And look for certain things, very subtle things that most of us don't really see that could really impact the application, how to catch them, how to correct them. And then leverage abstraction, the data vault, and the enterprise model for robust application architecture. So in this class, we cover not just how to build a model, and how to build it well, but how to fit it in with the rest of the organization. Every data model we build is a puzzle piece with some larger puzzle that we're creating. So these five objectives are covered across 11 modules. Module zero is all about getting started. So I'll talk about what data modeling is. I'll talk about why we do it, all the parts of a model. We'll practice reading a model, and then we introduce the scorecard. And the rest of the three-day class goes into detail into the scorecard. Module one covers correctness. Correctness means, does a data model do what the requirements need it to do? Module two covers completeness. Completeness means, do we have the right scope? Are all the requirements on the model and nothing else? And in the completeness module, we'll also talk about metadata. Module three covers scheme, and we'll go into detail on the five different types of models. We'll talk about conceptual, logical, physical, relational, dimensional, where NoSQL fits. Module four, we'll talk about structure. And I'll go through a whole bunch of things to look for on the model that could take an average model and make it amazing and lead to a really sound application. Module five will talk about abstraction, which is the use of generic structures. Like instead of calling customer a customer, we could call customer a party, for example. Party's an example. I'll talk about when to abstract and when to never abstract. Module six will talk about naming standards. Module seven, readability. So how do you arrange a model so it pulls the reader in, and they want to read everything in it, and it's easy for them to understand. Module 8 will talk about how to write clear, complete, correct definitions. Module 9 is about consistency. How do you build that model so it fits in with a larger architecture? Never design a chair unless you know the room it's going to go in. Never design the room unless you know the house it's going to go in. Same idea here. Every data model should fit in with some larger picture. Module 10 will talk about the data category, making sure the data coming in matches the metadata, matches the rest of the application.